Okay, Michael, what's the answer?
All right, so you kind of were walking us through it, but basically, if Y, I and HT agree, that means they're both negative or they're both positive. They're equal to each other. So when we multiply them together, we get 1. 1 times whatever our alpha thing is, some positive number is going to be positive. We're negating that, so it's negative. E to the negative something is something between 0 and 1, less than 1. So that's going to scale it down. So it looks like, and you know, assuming that everything else goes okay with the way that the normalization happens, right? It seems like it could be depends on the normalization.
Ah, so by the way, that's a good point. The z sub t is in fact whatever normalization constant you need at time t in order to make it all work out to be a distribution.
Correct. Then it's not going to change.
True.
But if some of them are correct and some of them are incorrect, the ones that are correct are going to decrease. And the ones that are incorrect are going to increase.
That's right. So what's the answer to the quiz?
Depends.
That's true. It does. That is exactly the right answer. It depends on what else is going on. You're correct.
But I feel like it should be decreases. Like, that's really mainly what happens.
That's also fair. The answer is, if this one is correct, that is, they agree, and you disagree on at least some of them, at least one other example, it will, in fact, decrease. So I could ask a similar question, which is, well, what happens when they disagree and at least one other example agrees? Then what happens?
Yeah, then it should increase. Oh, right. Oh, it's going to put more weight on the ones that it's getting wrong.
Exactly. And the ones that it's getting wrong must be the ones that are harder, or at least that's the underlying idea. All right, Michael, so you got it? So you understand what the equation's for?
Yeah, it seemed really scary at first, but it seems, you know, marginally less scary now. Because all that it's doing it in a particular way. I don't know why it's doing it in this particular way. But all it seems to be doing is the answers that it was getting wrong, it puts more weight on those. And the ones that it's getting right, it puts less weight on those. And then, the loop goes around again and it tries to make a new classifier.
Right. And since the ones that it's getting wrong are getting more and more weight, but we're guaranteed, or at least we've assumed, that we have a weak learner that will always do better than chance on any distribution, it means that you will always be able to output some learner that can get at least some of the ones that you were getting wrong right.